Welcome to the Soccer Academy. My name is Antonio Suave, and I'm your host. Today, we're coming to you from beautiful Guadalajara, Mexico. Hey, the Soccer Academy is brought to you by the good folks at the Global Foundation for Peace Through Soccer. And if you want to know more about the Global Soccer Foundation, go on to globalsoccerpeace.org. Always and everywhere, they're spreading a mission of peace through soccer. Hey, hey. Here with my man.
Hey.
All right, Jair Rangel, the man. You grew up in the little folks, right?
Yeah.
Atlas, and then you went on to Tecos.
Yeah,
right. Here in Guadalajara.
Yeah,
both. And now, how cool is it? You get to stand in the middle of this stadium. Is that the coolest thing ever or what?
It's the best thing that could ever happen to me.
I'll bet, because you grew up coming to the stadium, didn't you?
Yeah.
And as you know, Jair, every good soccer player has to stretch properly before, right? So we're gonna do a few sample stretches. What do you say?
Sure.
Okay, let's go right over left. And remember, all the way in, because what we're doing is we're practicing breathing at the same time. Yes, hold it. And then exhale. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Nice, let's shake. Shake, beautiful. Whatever we're doing to a rhythm, right?
Sure.
Because soccer is essentially a rhythm based sport, right? All right, so here we go. Let's get a little torso. Yeah, there it is, nice. Little faster. Let's get some jumping jacks. Yes, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yes. All right, so here's what we're gonna do now. We're gonna twist our body. Yes, keep it going. Twist it. Great stuff. Now look. We're in Mexico. We gotta start speaking some Spanish here, right?
Sure.
All right, so, ahora vamos a contar en español.
Okay.
Okay, let's take the instep, okay? Pull it back. There we are, all the way up. Uno, dos, tres, cuatro, cinco, seis, siete, ocho, nueve, diez, once, doce. You know what? I think I'm finally feeling it. What do you think?
I'm done.
All right, let's do it. All right, let's get to our drills, right?
Yeah.
Good stuff. Great stuff.
Cogiendo como centrales, aunque Angulo ya se le ve un poco más. Adelante, aquí está Jairo. Jairo levanta Quiñones. ¡Espor! Atacadón de Gudiño. El 1.96 le sirve a Raúl porque el impacto había sido fenomenal. Osvaldo Sánchez por parte de Por.
All right, as a classic follow-up to our one-touch drills, remember we were doing one-touch drills, right? As a classic follow-up, we want to work on the 1-2 pass, otherwise known as the wall pass. But what do you say here in Mexico in Spanish? How do you say it?
Pared,
which means wall, right?
Yeah.
All right, let's do it, man.
Let's do it.
All right, let's go. Always on my toes. Remember locking my ankle all the way through to the target. Yes, pared! Beautiful, I love it. Here we go, lock, pared! Yes! Pared! Yes, nice. Yes,
Antonio,
pared! 1-2, baby, pared! I'm loving it.
Antonio!
Pared! Yes! And there it is! Stay tuned. We'll be right back with more of the Soccer Academy from beautiful Guadalajara, Mexico. Welcome back to the Soccer Academy. We're in fantastic Guadalajara, Mexico. I'm now here in downtown Guadalajara, outside of the massive market called San Juan de Dios. And behind me is a church by the same name, San Juan de Dios, which means Saint John of God. And they tell me that you can find just about anything you want inside of this massive market. So let's go have a look. Right here in the Mercado San Juan de Dios, there is no shortage of fruit. As a matter of fact, it is an embarrassment of riches here in Mexico because Mexico produces some of the best fruit in the world. In fact, a lot of it is exported. Right here, we have cactus fruit, which happens to be one of my very favorites. And it grows on a cactus plant, and you don't need a lot of water. I'm here with Jocelyn, who's going to show us a little bit more about this amazing and wonderful cactus fruit. Okay, explícanos un poquito de la pitaya.
La pitaya es una fruta que se da solo 2 meses.
Solo 2 meses.
Solo 2 meses.
So you have to wait a long time to get this, right? And then you only have it for 2 months a year.
Sí. Y en todo el año ya no vas a encontrar pitaya más que esos únicos 2 meses.
Y la gente tiene que esperar mucho. Y después pagar mucho, ¿no? ¿Pagar más?
No es cara.
Gracias a Dios.
Es muy difícil de conseguirla.
Sí.
Porque vienen cactus. Todo esto está lleno de espinas.
Sí, es el problema, ¿no? Because what it comes with the espinas, right? All of the thorns, so it's very difficult.
Sí, pero estas ya vienen limpias.
Ya no tienen
espinas.
Look at this baby. But look at the amazing color. That's what's incredible to me, right?
Sí.
El color está fantástico. You know what, we can use, hay más. Pero podemos utilizar este color con las playeras de fútbol. Because they're so pretty. Oh my gosh, I'll tell you what. This just happens to be one of my favorites. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take a big bite out of this. And I'll bet you this is great for soccer players as well, because it gives you a lot of energy. And I hear it helps with your digestive system too. Right? Okay, here we go. Oh, baby, one of the best I've ever had. It's the Wheel of Fortune. No, I'm just kidding. Actually, it's the Rotonda. And this Rotonda is very famous because it is called La Rotonda de los Jaliscienses Ilustres, which means the Rotonda of the illustrious people from Jalisco. All right, if you can believe it, I was walking through downtown Guadalajara and guess what I found? Two rival teams, Chivas and America. And let me tell you, these guys are gonna go at it. Pelean. Well now, careful. Uh-oh. There it is. Who won? All right. There you have it. Chivas versus America right here in Guadalajara. Hey, I have searched long and hard. Finally, I found them. The double-decker buses right here in Guadalajara. And you know what? They do a tour around the city, and that tour is called the Tapatio Tour right on the double-decker bus. Stay tuned, we'll be right back with more of the Soccer Academy from Guadalajara, Mexico.
Thank you.
Welcome back to the Soccer Academy. We're in beautiful Guadalajara, Mexico. Just in case you thought Cinderella only lived in a storybook, I don't think that's right. You know why? Because behind me, I think we have her horse and carriage. That's right, right here in Guadalajara. I'm here in Guadalajara in the middle of La Plaza de la Liberación, and that means the Plaza of Liberation. And behind me is the beautiful theater known as El Teatro Degollado. And it was founded in 1866. Hey guys, here are a couple of fun facts. Did you know that many of the things that we know as being culturally Mexican are actually from here in the state of Jalisco? And what am I talking about? I'm talking about charros, which means cowboys. I'm talking about mariachis. And of course, the soccer player Chicharito is from here. And finally, the great guitarist, Carlos Santana. Oye, ¿cómo va? Qué lindo. Hey, I know I'm not good enough to be singing in here. All right, now we get to work on something really, really cool. It is called the shoulder pass. But we want to be careful, don't we?
Yeah.
Because if we use this part of the arm, it becomes a handball. And what do you call it here?
Mano.
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 Man, no mano, right?
No.
We've got to go with the shoulder, so we got to be intentional, and we got to make sure that we adjust our body properly, right? And we move into the pass. We only use this rarely in a game, and we only use it once we have perfected it. All right, that's it. I'm intentional, and I'm guiding the ball, right? I'm guiding the ball back with my shoulder. Not my hand, not my arm. Yeah, that's what it looks like. I'm stepping in and pushing forward. I'm always guiding the ball. All right, we're never just hitting at the ball. We're intentional in the way that we guide the ball. Sometimes we can step in, use our head, but then we go back, use our shoulder. We can step in, use our head, but then we go back, use our shoulder. Yes, sir. What do you say?
Yeah.
Guess what? We get to practice one of the coolest drills in the world right now. We get to practice one of my all-time favorites, the Cruyff turn. Named after who? The great Johan Cruyff, right? Who played for the national team of Holland. Yeah, he was one of the best. So this pass, this turn, because it can be used as a pass, it can be used as a turn, it can even be used as a shot on goal, right? Was made famous by the great Johan Cruyff, so we call it a Cruyff turn. What I'm gonna do is emulate the game situation, because I wanna take my man who's marking me, I wanna take him in another direction, right? And I wanna make him believe I'm gonna be turning to one side when I'm actually turning to another, okay? So I'm gonna make believe that I have the opponent right here at my back. So I'm gonna take him away, fake, and then I'm coming and I'm calling, yes! And I turn. And remember, everything we do is intentional and it has to be game-like, okay? So, I'm taking my man, I fake, yes! There it is, it's coming. We're gonna do it again. I start from this point, go back, make a fake. Yes, here it is! Yes, I love it! Yes, I'm taking him away. Yes! Yes, I love it! When I'm turning with the ball, in a tight space, the ball has got to be close to my feet, right? So here we go, affirmative, yes! All right, yes, come on. And there it is, inside of El Estadio Jalisco.
Here in the Mercado de San Juan de Dios, they also have traditional ponchos, that's right. And they have all of the big soccer teams emblazoned upon a particular poncho. Now in the States, we sometimes call these ponchos, but really here in Mexico, they're called ponchos. And you know what? It's really heavy, so it's gotta be kind of cold outside, but it's gonna be great to go see a soccer game in cold weather with my poncho. Stay tuned, we'll be right back with more of the Soccer Academy from Guadalajara, Mexico. Welcome back to the Soccer Academy. We're in Guadalajara, Mexico. All right, you cannot come to Mexico without looking at the piñatas. And this is a classic here in Mexico. They use it at parties and they fill this with candy and then they try to hit it while blindfolded, isn't that right? Okay, so I'm here with Jocelyn once again, and she's gonna explain to us these beautiful and wonderful piñatas because they're a little smaller than we're used to in the States, right? So here we have Paw Patrol. Pero tú me dijiste que es hecho a mano?
Sí.
Okay, so these are all made by hand, and they are beautiful, they're amazing. I can't believe the amount of detail that's on each one of these. So explícanos de este.
Esta es una muñeca tradicional.
Una muñeca. Yeah, a doll. Beautiful. Oh my gosh, look at this.
Su collar.
Oh my gosh. Wow, this is incredible. And then the colors and everything together, only to be smashed at some point right during a party. That's the unfortunate thing. But we can also keep these things because they're really beautiful and they're made by hand.
De hecho, la usan más como adorno.
Sí. Okay, so we don't have to beat it up, right? Like a regular piñata. We can actually hang it in our rooms and we can put candy inside and we can pick out the candy without destroying the piñata, right?
Sí.
That's what I'm talking about. I'd rather have a situation like that. All right, so when you come back to Mexico here, come and get a piñata. You've got to get one of these. Right here in the middle of Guadalajara is the magnificent cathedral. It is called La Catedral Metropolitana de Guadalajara, which means the Metropolitan Cathedral or the main cathedral of Guadalajara. And it was consecrated in October of the year 1716, if you can believe it. Hey, as a soccer player, this is what I'm talking about. I've been going around and around this massive market, the Mercado de San Juan de Dios, and finally I found it. I came upon the motherlode. That's right, las playeras, the jerseys, the soccer jerseys from here in Mexico. And here in Guadalajara, we have some of the best. There is Chivas, of course. Look at that, colorful, beautiful, with Chivas on the back. Yeah, I'm loving it. And then look at this, Club America. And even on the back, they got things happening. And they also have this beautiful jersey from Leones Negros. Leones Negros actually plays in the second division here in Mexico called Liga de Expansión. And then there is this America jersey, beautiful, fantastic. And then of course comes the everlasting team, Atlas, and there it is. So you know what? Remember, if you get here to Guadalajara, come to the Mercado de San Juan de Dios and get yourself a beautiful and colorful soccer jersey. Thanks for joining us here on the Soccer Academy. And remember, if you want to know more about the Soccer Academy, just log on to socceracademy.tv. That's socceracademy.tv. God bless you. We'll see you again soon.